also they can catch up with us. 541-321. All right, I'm going to call to order. Today is Tuesday, January 4th, 2022. This is the first Rules, Confirmations, and Public Elections Committee of the New Year. So happy New Year, committee members, and to those that's here joining us today. I don't have my whole packet. Nevertheless, I think we only have two confirmations. Right. No, we have a few.
We got four.
I don't have my packet with me, but nevertheless, we will go ahead and begin. Committee members, we'll start with elections and confirmations first, and then we'll come back to dealing with our business as a committee as it relates to resolutions. Is there any objections to that?
No.
All right. Seeing none. Looks like we have a Fair Commissioners Board appointment of Mr. Mario Avila. Okay. For a term expiring March 30th, 2023. We're not going to put you on the spot or anything. This room is oriented a little weird. Thank you for being here. And just briefly tell us why you're seeking to serve.
Well, I could see the fairgrounds from my backyard, and it's an important part of Nashville. It's an important impact to my direct neighborhood, but also the rest of the city. And given the work that I do in terms of community involvement and poverty at the University of Vanderbilt, I think this is an opportunity to serve the city on a commission.
Okay, thank you so much for that. Is there any questions from the committee members?
I have a question.
Yes.
We've gotten some emails, and like I know I got a call today, kind of speaking to your background and potentially a conflict of interest related to your employment situation.
Yeah.
Could you speak to that?
It was interesting. I received that email too from a gentleman that I guess lives or his family lives in the Wedgwood Houston area. I think they just confused as to my role at the university. I run a center that was funded by the Turner Family Foundation, and we had some interns that had done some work at the fairgrounds as interns that were not compensated for a needs assessment for the fairgrounds. I think he's under the understanding that I know the owners of the soccer complex, and because John Ingram is on the board of the university, that there's a direct conflict, which I don't see any. I've been to one soccer game in Nashville, so I don't see. And that was also, I think, when he alluded to a presentation that our students gave in 2016. So, yeah.
Okay. And so I guess a follow up to that, how would you handle if you felt like if there was potentially a conflict of interest, how would you handle that?
So I think that's a great question. I think twofold, right? One is from the attorney that supports the commission in seeing any of those conflicts, and also by the university, right? So the general counsel from the university will quickly step in and say this is a conflict and you shouldn't be involved in it. So unfortunately, there'll be too many high-paid lawyers on both sides that'll make that decision. But for me, it's very easy and cut and dry. Let alone I don't represent the university.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just a staff member, so I can't make decisions for the university. So,
thank you for answering that.
Great questions, Councilwoman Evans. Councilman Syracuse.
Thank you. Appreciate you being here. I certainly think you're very qualified, and I would love to see you on the board. I just want to point out, because I wouldn't be doing my job as a member of the Rules Committee, that we just got your questionnaire today, right? And the rules of procedure do say that if we don't get it within a certain period of time, that we have to technically, by rule, push this out. So I think that what's coming is a potential suspension of the rule, which I'm okay with, but do you want to speak to that? Are you aware of any of the logistical issues? And did you send your stuff in to the clerk and whatnot?
And I had, and I resent it, so I was... I'm on the special bombing commission.
Right. Yes.
So then I resent it, and then I believe someone emailed me back and said, "Hey, here's the questionnaire." So it was confusing. There was a document that I signed.
Gotcha.
It was like, any conflict of interest, or there was a PDF that I had signed, and then there was another one that was the form that I filled out. So when I got that link again, I filled it out.
So you did get it on, you sent it in on time? We're trying to figure out if this was a logistical issue with our clerk resigning, and if it didn't get in there on time or whatnot, but
yeah, the original email I received was on the 29th of December.
Okay.
So.
Just as a procedure thing, we're going to need to suspend the rules, I think, in order to take this.
Yeah,
I think that's in the works.
Yeah. I believe Councilman Sledge, his council member, will be making that suspension from the floor. As a committee, we're just taking up the appointment. So is there a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Okay. It's been moved and properly seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, Ms. Davila will be recommended for the Fair Commissioners Board appointment. Don't be alarmed with the procedural on the floor on the floor tonight. So okay, most of the body should be aware of it, and I believe your council member is going to speak to you as it relates to it as well. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay. What was that for? New Year, I tell y'all. Okay, next we have Fair Commissioners Board appointment of Mr. Jasper Hendricks for a term expiring January 4th, 2027. We do have Mr. Hendricks here. Mr. Hendricks, will you tell us briefly why you're seeking to serve?
Hi, so as a newer resident to Davidson County, we've been here for 5 years now, I decided I wanted to give back, you know, and get involved in my community. So over the last few years, just been investigating ways to learn more about city government, and actually just finished the Mayor's Neighborhood Academy, in which they asked us to think about ways that we want to serve a little bit more. And so in doing my research, I reached out to Fabian and, you know, and inquired about the Fair Board, really just doing research on the different boards that were available. That was one of my choices. And the next thing you know, I get a call and he's like, hey, the list that you sent, you know, one of your top three choices is available. And here we are. It was indeed an honor to be asked to serve, you know, this great city that has been so great to me and my family over the last 5 years. So.
Okay, any questions from committee members? All right, seeing none, can I get a motion?
So moved.
Second. Moved and properly seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, Mr. Jaspers is recommended for the Fair Commissioners Board. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We also have a committee that we need to take up. Many of you are aware that our clerk is no longer with us, so it's up to us to appoint an interim clerk. So this is the Metropolitan Clerk appointment of Mr. Austin Cowell as interim clerk for a term of less than 6 months. Is there any discussion, committee members, as it relates to that? Concerns? Seeing none. All right. Can I get a motion?
So moved.
It's been moved and properly seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? All right. Clerk Kyle.
Blessings to you.
did they tell you I'm a handful? Okay, we're moving on to, I don't believe he's here, the Solid Waste Region Board appointment of Dr. Padgett for a term expiring December 12, 2024. I believe we're going to do a one-meeting deferral for Dr. Padgett. Can I get a motion?
So moved.
Moved and properly second for a one-meeting deferral for Dr. Padgett. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Councilman Syracuse.
Sorry.
All right. Now we're on to committee business. This is Resolution RS-2022-1309, sponsor Vercher. This approves the election of certain notaries public for Davidson County. Can I get a motion?
So moved.
It's been moved and properly seconded. Many of you were that this is pretty much routine. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, resolution is recommended. We also have RS-2022-1323, 2023, Councilman Sledge, request the Metro government investigate the feasibility of providing free parking for public meetings held at the historic Metro courthouse. Do you have a letter approved from the sponsor? Can I get a motion?
Been moved
and properly seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is recommended. It looks like we're going to be taking up seven late files. There's RS 2022-1327, sponsors Robert and O'Connell, recognizes the 125th anniversary of R.H. Lloyd Publishing Corporation. There is a late amendment on that by Councilman O'Connell.
So?
I think that late amendment is just some language clarifications and like Mr. Mrs. versus, you know, that kind of thing. So
okay.
It's just clerical.
Okay.
It was the LaDonna board is Dr. Board and they just changed it to add the doctor.
Yeah.
So we got a motion?
Yeah, so moved.
Okay.
Second.
All of all right. Resolution is recommended.
No objections to the late amendment.
Okay. No objections to the late amendment. Thank you, Councilwoman Johnson. They got it out of order for me, but it's okay. Okay, now we're on to late items. Resolution to repeal resolution RS 2018-1171 related to the vehicle inspection program. This Councilman Roden. Councilman Roden.
Okay, good morning.
Madam Chair, this was brought to me by legal last night before finance, and we brought it up and discussed it in finance, and it's late filed. We had put the amendment on in the last meeting to end the emissions program. It was going to be on January the 14th. Legal came to me and said that the contract is 30 days and that the emissions folks would like it to be, they would like that the contract to be what it is, and so to keep us out of legal issues and court, legal asked me to just do a late filed amendment ending it in 30 days from tonight or when it's passed, rather than the January 14th.
Okay.
And so that's all it is.
All right. Any questions, concerns from committee members?
No. Nope.
Any objections to the late file?
Nope.
Okay.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
Oh, you're welcome. This is also moving on to our next late file item. This is a late amendment to RS 2022-1314, Allen and Evans. This approves an intergovernmental agreement between the Metro Nashville Police Department and the City of Cookeville Police Department for the distribution of state grant funds to assist with investigations of internet crimes against children. Chair Allen.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I would love for someone on the committee to move it, and then I have amendments to each of these.
It's late, so it's just...
Right, we don't have to move it.
Yeah.
Well, I have
approval of the...
I'm wondering if we can take all of these amendments at the same time, because I think they are all sort of for the same reason. So if it's okay with you to expedite.
Is everyone here? Yeah, these are all yours.
Yep.
Okay. I didn't look at the agenda.
That's okay.
All right, Chair. So just for matter of record, also a late amendment. That's the same.
Like five in a row.
That's the same. Yes. So late amendment to, these are different resolutions though. Late amendment to RS 2022-1315, late amendment to RS 2022-1316, RS 2022-1317, RS 2022-1318, and the caption is the same for the viewing audience that I've already read.
Yeah,
so
they're all about internet crimes against children. There were several different locations. Springfield, Williamson County, Tennessee Association of Sheriffs, and two other places that I'm forgetting. So I'm going to let Ms. Eitlin explain what the amendment corrects.
So on all of these resolutions, the grant contract number that was referenced in the attached grant contract was incorrect. So this amendment substitutes a new grant contract where the only difference is a correction of that contract number.
Okay. How did we get that inaccurate for a contract? That's a legal document. I'm just asking.
I was going to say, it came through our office as administration legislation, so we were alerted to the error.
Okay.
I have no objection.
Nope.
Any other questions? Okay, there's no objections. Thank you, Chair Allen.
Thank you. Hello, you told me you got us here.
Last but not least, it is your last, Brad. Councilman Withers, late amendment to ours 2022-1321, a resolution authorizing Eastwood Deli Company LLC to construct and install an aerial encroachment at 1896 Eastland Avenue. Councilman Withers.
Well, this is an aerial encroachment for a sign in an existing building over that's built up to the sidewalk, like we like in urban neighborhoods. It's an aerial encroachment for a new sign for this is, used to be the Wild Cow Restaurant, which moved to a different space in East Nashville, and Eastwood Deli Company is taking over that space. And then yesterday, I guess we learned that there was something, there was a certificate that hadn't been signed yet for insurance. And so I was able to reach out to the business owners, they got that in today. So we'd like to go ahead and do this as a late fall amendment just to keep that aerial encroachment approval moving forward in the town limit.
Okay, any questions from committee members? Any objections?
No objections.
All right, thank you so much, Councilman Withers. Madam Vice Chair, in lieu of Russ Pulley. Is that all our agenda items?
It is. I would move to adjourn.
All right, move to adjourn. Rules of confirmation, public, this is adjourned. Thank you.